Hello everyone. I hope you all are safe and healthy. Today, in 11th Commerce Economics, we are going to discuss chapter number 1, Economics and Introduction. This is the third part of the chapter. In previous two part, we have divided the chapter in basically three part. We have seen two parts previously. Now this is the third one. But before going to the third part, let's revise what we have studied in first and second part. Okay, so first we have studied what is the meaning of economics. So different words are there and different word has their different meaning. Just take a snapshot of this particular thing so it will help you in MCQ based questions. Then economic in Indian thought. You know that there are four different purushas: dharma, earth, kama and moksha. And what is the meaning of that? And the earth shastra, the word earth, that means the second purushart of Indian philosophy. From that, we correlate the word economics with this. Then, as per the Indian thought, what is economics? 2500 years ago, the Kautilya has given some idea in his book, Arthashastra. Okay, so that is the Indian thought, the thing is about Indian thought. Then, the Greek philosopher Aristotle the Great has given some book, and in which he has given some ideas. And same way, the Wealth of the Nation book, which was written in the year 1776 by the father of modern economy, Adam Smith. He has given some Western concepts related with the economy that we have seen. Then we have seen the four different authors and their definition. One definition is given by Adam Smith, one is given by the Alfred Marshall, one is given by the Robbins, and the last one, that is fourth one, is given by the Paul Simons. Here we have end our first part. In second part, what we have discussed? In second part, we have started with what is economic activity, and we have seen different examples of economic activity. Okay, then here we have seen that the non-economic activity, where what is called as non-economic activity, why it is called as non-economic activity, and what are some examples of non-economic activity. Then the economy is basically divided into two parts, and we have discussed that basic two parts of economy, that is micro and the macro one. In detail, when it comes to the microeconomics, we are dealing with the behavior or the study of only individual unit or individual person, that is called as microeconomic. But when we are studying the facts related as a whole, that means as a nation, then these concepts will become the macroeconomic. Okay, and then we have seen what is the presentation of information in data related with economics, what data we are collecting and how we are presenting. So basically there are three different types of presentation: one that is descriptive manner, second by the way of data tables, and third by the way of graphs. Descriptive manner, in which we are describing, that means we are writing everything, each and every point we are writing in detail, that is called as descriptive manner. Then by the way of data table, we are creating different type of data tables in that. And by the way of graph, what we are creating? We are creating graph or the diagrams. So these are the basic three funda to present information or the data in economics. Then what is the importance of statistical information? These two subjects, statistics and economy, they are correlated. So what is the importance of statistics when it comes to collection? Then we have seen it in detail. There are different four different types of importance of statistical information. Then what requisites or what aspects we need to consider while making any kind of diagram, charts and graphs. So there are basically three different perspective which we should be kept in mind when we are preparing the data. So we have seen that. So here we have end our second session, part 2, and now we are starting with the third part. Okay, so I hope you have particularly seen the first and the second part, and if you haven't seen the first and the second one, I have put that in the link of that particular part 1 and part 2 in the description box. Just go through that, or otherwise search the channel on YouTube, subscribe it, and you are able to see as many videos are posted for the subject of economics and accounts in this. Then let's start with the new thing, that is presenting quantitative or the numerical information in the diagram or the graphs. So when the data are normally in the numerical forms, okay, when you are collecting the data, Now finally, what you need to do? You need to present the data in different forms. So by which way we are preparing? By the way of diagrams, or by the way of graphs, or by the way of chart we are using that. So frequently, if it is a linear relation or non-linear relation, we are normally using such type of diagrams in the study. One, that is bar diagram. Second, that is grouped bar diagram. And third one is pie diagram. These all three of this you have studied in standard 8 and 9. We just need to revise this. Let's see each in detail. Starting with the first one, that is bar diagram. Now, what is called as bar diagram? A bar diagram is which represents grouped data with the rectangular bars with the length proportional and values which they represent. Let's see, here is the table. Wheat production in India. So what we are studying? We are studying how much production of wheat is done in India in different years. So here the different years are given. Okay. The year 70-71, 80-81, 90-91, 2000-2001 and 2010-11. So these are the different years which are given, and the production is given in different tons, lakh tons. Lakh tons means, that means you have to make different zeros after this. So it's in lakhs tons. So when you are preparing any kind of table, you have to first, you should be clear in your mind that the production is in lakh tons. So first, what we have done, we have put that things over here. Production in lakh tons. Then what we are putting in x-axis and what we are putting in y-axis, that should be there. If any kind of dependent variable is there, that should be put on here, and the independent will be over here. So on x-axis, what we have taken? We have taken the different variables, that is year 1970, 71, 80, 81, 1990. So five different years are here, and we have put the figures and we have drawn the chart. Okay, here it is written 0.5 centimeter, that is called to 10 tons. That means on one scale 5.5 centimeter, that means half of the centimeter, the 10 tons is there. So by that way we have created. So it has become very easy to understand. The wheat production in the 70-71 has increased to, in the year 1980-81, it is also increased in the different years. So by this way, if someone is not good at statistics, even though he is able to understand, so this is the benefit of the bar diagram. Okay, so from this, if I ask the question, in which year the highest number of wheat production is happened? So in the year 2010-11. In which year almost 50 lakh tons production has done? So it is done in the year 1990-91, 2000-2001 and 2010-11. In these 3 years, more than 50 lakh tons of production is done. So by this diagram, I am able to understand, and everyone is able to understand, this is the basic representation of the bar diagram. Okay, so this is the first part. Second is grouped or the clustered bar diagram. Now, the first one, that is only represented of the group data, but that is only one representation. There is only one thing is here. Okay. But in this one, there are three different things. So we have to prepare grouped or the clustered bar diagram. The chart which are used when the dependent variables is grouped more than one category. So what is dependent variable? These are the dependent variable. Okay, they are more than one category: male, female and the total. That means this total will become here. Okay, so male, female and the total percentage. And what we have done, these years we have taken over here on the x-axis, and finally male, female and total, we have divided it. For male, this signature we have taken. For female, we are noting it as blank. And for total, we are using the stripes. So, as per the information was there, and we have put it in a figure. So, from this, we are able to compare whatever we want. So, basically, it is for a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 years of data are there. This is the data is taken from the socio-economic survey of Gujarat 2011 and 12. So economic survey is done at the end of the budgeting year. That means when new budget is passed, before that day, the previous year's allocation and their comparison and what work the government has done, it is shown by the data, and that data will be called as economic survey. And this is the economic survey of Gujarat. So by economic survey of Gujarat, we have found these things. So now, what is the survey? It is a literacy rate in Gujarat. What is the literacy rate in Gujarat? So from this information, we are able to know that in the year 1951, it was only 21%, and it has increased to 79.31% in total. But where the male population has higher educations, but than the female one. Same here in this one. So comparatively, if you see, every year there is an increase in literacy rate among the male candidates. Same way in the year 51 and 61, there is only a marginal difference. There is a decrease, or otherwise there will be increase. Rest of the years, it is increased every year, every 10 years, that means every decade where the population is counted. Then the total percentage or literacy rate is increasing every year. It is 21% and then 60. It has to 61.29 in the year, 69.14 in 2001. And finally, in the year 2011, it is 79.30. So that is shown in this diagram. Okay. So I hope you have understood this. Then the third part, that is pie diagram. Now what is called a pie diagram? When the information is given and you are using the statistical graph, which is divided into different sectors and in a numerical proportion. For example, here the NI, that means national income, is given in percentage. So for the percentage, that means the total will become 100. So agriculture, it is 13.9%, industry, it is 26.2%, and service sector, it is 59.9%. So when we make the total of all the three, it will become 100. Now see that the numerical data is proportionally converted into degrees. What we are doing, we are converting that into degree. Degree, that means 360 degree we are converting, and we have devoted it in a different name. Same way it is taken from the source of Economic Survey of India 2014 and 15. From this, we are able to analyze that agriculture sector has lesser national income per share compared to the different two sectors, and highest is from the service sector only. Okay, so basically there are three sectors: one that is agriculture sector, second that is industrial sector, and third that is service sector. So highest income is generated from the service sector, then second highest will be generated from the industrial sector, and last one, the lowest income, is generated from the agriculture sector, where there are highest population of people who are working in the agriculture sector, even though we are getting lowest incomes. So that is again an issue in terms of economy. So I hope you have understood this. Now the last one and the final topic of this presentation, that is importance of economics. Why we are studying this particular subject? So basically, economy is an important understand behavior of the human being and the society and the state while managing the everyday activities and scientific theories and the principles for guiding the professional decision making. Why we are studying? We are basically studying this for these two things. One, that is for understanding everyday's behavior, to understand what is happening in routine life, what is happening in daily life. And second, that is for the economic importance, as economy has lots of importance in present scenario. That's why we are learning it. Okay, let's see. Understanding the economy behavior is divided into two parts. One, that is understanding the international event, what India is doing in business with the different countries. Everything should be studied over here. And second, that is understanding the historical events. Historical events, that means the event which has happened in the past. So if you have proper knowledge related with the economy, you are able to understand what actually happened in the past. Then the economic importance, that is when it comes to the professional part, decision making by the individuals. When we have to make any kind of decision, we have to keep economic in the mind. Then understanding the government policy. Government is changing day by day, and they are changing the rules day by day. So for that, we need to understand the economy first. And last one, that is professional decision making. Any kind of professional decision is going to be taken. It shouldn't be taken without the help of economy. Okay. So basically, these are the importance of economics. Let's see in detail. First, A portion, understanding everyday's behavior. Where what we are understanding first, when we are understanding the international events. Some international events affect lives of people in several countries like USA, UK, Russia, China. People are living not only in India, they are living in lots of countries. For example, someone is Indian citizen, but he is staying in US, he is staying in UK, Russia or China. So if anything happens in this country and the other country is in relation with us, then we have to understand that. Same way, when the modern times have the increasing information available in the public only, and continuously improving the technology, the scope of economics is increasing every day in the lives of expanding. If you want to expand something, you need to understand the economy. Anything happened between the two countries, that should be known by us, because it's everyday's behavior, we have to understand that. Then understanding the historical events, what happened in the previous, that means what Indian, that means what the British government had done with us, what is British Raj, what is British rule, what is labor movement, what is home charges, that should be understood. If we know economics in better way, we are able to understand these things very, very thoroughly. So, this is the basic importance of economy. And what is the economic importance? Previous one was the our, that means on an individual level, we have to understand, understanding. Okay, but this is what is the basic importance of economy. First one, that is decision making for the individual. If we can predict well about the economy, we are able to take any kind of decisions. For example, if the price of the potato is going to be increased in 2 days, we know that we should take or we should make a stock of some potatoes. Okay, so this is some decision making which we can take by individual policies or by understanding the importance of economy. Same way, when we are understanding the government policy, for example, RBI is every 2 months they are making new policies, monetary policies. So what they were doing, they were changing the repo rates, reverse repo rate, they were changing CRR, SLRs. So that we will study in next few chapters. So not going in further detail on that, but what policies the government is making, that should be understood by the people only if we know maximum about the economy as a subject. Okay, so that is the second most important thing. And third one, that is professional decision making. Any kind of professional decision making should be there. We should know the theories and the principle which is given by the authors, and we have to collaborate that with the statistics. And finally, we should come on some conclusion about the price determination, when determination, employment factors, degree of competition. By this way, we can learn, or by this way, we can do some professional decision making about any of the products. So this is about the first unit, where it is divided in three different parts. I have put the link in the description box. Please go through it, see it once. If you have any kind of doubt, just put that doubt in comment section. I will answer that doubt over there. Okay. But a humble request is that please like, share and subscribe to the channel Economics by Pratik Majumdar. As I know that there is increase, the views are increasing, the subscription are increasing, but I'm not getting the total input, that means output what I'm putting in. So requesting you, please like, share and subscribe to the channel. That's all for today. Please see all the parts, and any doubt, please put that in comment box. Thank you. Jai Hind.